And welcome to the next part of the bell drives. Now actually we are designing these bell drives. It means in the design basically we have to select the material first. So material selection and getting the dimensions of that particular component, both the things are important. So first we have seen how we can get the dimensions of the component, and now we will see how we can select the material, because for different applications different materials are suitable. So according to the suitability of the application, the material has to be selected for the different components of the flat as well as V belts. So the flat belts are marketed in the form of coils, and they are also available for a wide range of width, thickness, weight and material. So while designing it, we are going to get certain requirements for the belt to be used for a particular application, but that kind of belt material as well as the weight of the material or the thickness and the width, it should be available in the market. So and accordingly actually we are rounding up our dimensions towards the standard values which are available in the market. So now depending upon the requirement, one has to cut the required belt length from the available length of the belt, and then join the ends of that belt together and make the coil of it. So once we cut the required length of belt, then we have to join that belt properly, because the belt normally gets snapped from the improper joints. So the best way is to use a cemented belt from the factory itself, or with care one can join these belts with various types of clips that are available in the market. Okay, so now there are different materials available for the belt. So the materials such as leather, rubber, plastic, fabric, these different materials are available. Okay, so this leather is actually a oak tanned or chrome tanned material, and sometimes rubber is a canvas or cotton duck impregnated with rubber. So for greater tensile strength, the rubber belts are reinforced with steel cords or nylon cords, while in case of plastics, the thin plastic sheets with rubber layers are used for the belts. Now in case of fabric, the canvas or woven cotton ducks are there. So the belt thickness can be built up with a number of layers. So the number of layer is actually called as ply. So single ply, double ply, triple ply, like this. So more is the number of plies, it means more is the thickness of that particular belt. So the belt material is chosen depending upon the use and the application. So leather oak tanned belts and rubber belts are most commonly used, but the plastic belts have a very good strength, almost twice the strength of the leather belt. So fabric belts are used for temporary or short period of. So now we will see some typical belt specifications. So generally the belts are specified on the following parameters. So material of the belt is specified, and the decision of the material depends upon the type of service. Second, the number of ply and the thickness are specified for the belt, and the third is the maximum belt stress per unit width of the belt is specified. So the ply is actually the number of layers, therefore the number of ply is decided depending upon the belt tensile strength required for a given power transmission, and the maximum belt stress per unit width. So under this, the belts are subjected to tensile load only, and therefore the allowable tensile load depends on the allowable stress on that belt and its cross-sectional area. So stress and the cross-sectional area, these are the two important things to be considered here. So it is customary to provide the belt stress value for a given belt thickness and per unit belt width. Hence, a designer has to select a belt thickness and then calculate the required belt width. Otherwise, one can calculate the belt cross-section area and then adjust the belt thickness and width from the standards. So, belt width or belt thickness, any one parameter out of this you have to decide, and either you can find out. And also this maximum belt stress is dependent on the belt speed, and therefore the maximum belt stress for a given belt thickness and per unit belt width is provided either for different belt speeds or for a specific speed. Okay. At the same time, one more specification of the belt is a density of the belt material. So this is required for calculating the centrifugal force which is going to act over the belt, and this is generally provided as a per unit length, per unit cross section. Another important specification in the about the belt is the coefficient of friction of the belt material. So it is important to know the coefficient of friction between the belt material and the pulley material. So you will find different combinations of the belt material and the pulley material in the data book. Now, as the belt stress is specified by the manufacturer in the catalogs, so when we are going to design our problem or our requirement, so in that case we need to modify this belt stress. So there is one factor called as speed correction factor, which is to be used to modify the belt stress. So when the maximum belt stress per unit width is given for a specified speed, because they are specifying this value of the maximum belt stress at a particular value of the speed, and if our speed requirement is different than what is specified there in the catalog, then you have to use this speed correction factor. So this will modify this belt stress when the drive is operating at a speed other than the specified one. At the same time, there is one more parameter, that is angle of wrap, because while specifying this belt stress, they are giving or they are using the angle of wrap as 180 degree, and if our angle of wrap in our pulley, if it is different than this, means if it is less than or if it is more than 180, in that case also we have to modify this factor by using this angle of wrap condition. So the maximum stress values are given for an angle of wrap of 180 degree for both the pulleys, that is pulleys are of same diameter, and reduction of the belt stress is to be considered for angle of wrap less than 180. So belt stress is to be reduced by 3% for each 10 degree lesser angle of wrap as specified in a handbook. And for example, suppose if the angle of wrap is 160, then the belt stress is to be reduced by 6%, because for every 3% we are reducing it by for every 10%, for every 10% there is a reduction of 3%. Okay, so if we are reducing this angle of contact by 20 degree, that means for 20 degree, 3 plus 3, so 6% will be the reduction of the stress. So this factor is given as CW. As this speed correction factor is given as CSPD, so we are going to give this particular factor as angle of wrap factor as CW. Now we will go for understanding the next content of this particular slide. So the major design considerations for designing any belt drives are, first, the transmission ratio. So there is certain limitation of this transmission ratio, so according to that you have to use this transmission ratio. Then second important design criteria is the center distance, so which depends upon the available space. If the available space is more, you can go for larger center distance. If the space is less, accordingly you have to go for lower value of the center distance. So in the case of flat belt drives, there is not much limitation of the center distance. Generally the center distance is taken as more than twice the sum of the pulley diameters. While if the center distance is too small, then rapid flexing of the belt takes place and some amount of belt life will lost. So next parameter is the diameter of the pulleys. So depending upon the driving and driven shaft speeds, the pulley diameters are to be calculated and selected from the available sizes. So there are some standard pulley sizes are available. So whatever the values you will come across while doing the calculations, you have to round up that value towards a standard value which is available in the data book. Then next design consideration parameter is nothing but belt speed. So it is recommended that the belt speed should be within 15 meter per second to 25 meter per second. In this range only your belt drive should be designed. At the same time, the belt drive is designed based on the design power, so which is the modified required power, because we are going to calculate the rated power, and then that rated power will be modified by using a modification factor which is called the service factor. And this service factor depends on how many hours of working actually it is being provided over there, or how many hours of work will be taken out from that particular belt drive, or how many hours it will be running continuously, then the type of shock loads expected and the nature of duty. So hours of running, then type of load acting on it and the nature of duty, on this your service factor depends, and this service factor when you multiply with your rated power gives you the design power which is expected from that particular drive. So now after understanding these design considerations, now we will go for the selection of belt from the manufacturer's catalog. So the first requirements vary. So if we are to select the flat belt from manufacturer's catalog, we should have following data available with us at the initial stage. So how much power is required to be transmitted, that should be known to us. Then what is the input speed and the output speed desired, what is the center distance between the input and the output pulley, and what type of load is acting over that. So these contents, if it is there, then we can go for the selection of the belt from the manufacturer's catalog. Now here we will take one example of a catalog given by the Dunlop Rubber Company. So according to that catalog, in that catalog actually they have specified the value of maximum power transmitted by the belt. Okay, and so if we have to find out the maximum power transmission capacity of your belt drive, then you initially have to calculate the rated power requirement, and then you have to multiply it by a load correction factor, or also called a service factor. And this load correction factor, we are denoting it by FA. So this depends on the type of load condition. So normally it will be 1. If it is a steady kind of loads, like in case of centrifugal pumps which will be having very steady load, in that case the value of this FA is 1.2. if there is a intermittent type of load applications, like in case of a compressor, then it will be 1.3. and if there is a shock loads, like in case of hammers, grinders, in that case the load factor, load correction factor becomes 1.5. it means it will go on increasing as the type of load will be changing. So this factor, if you multiply to the rated power, you will get the maximum power transmission capacity expected from that particular belt. Similarly, if your arc of contact is less than 180 degree, in that case the factor which is to be multiplied is called as FT, that is the power transmission capacities of the belt are developed for 180 degree arc of contact. So in practice the arc of contact are different for different applications. So when the arc of contact is less than 180 degree, there is an additional tension in the belt, to account for which a factor called as arc of contact factor is used. So you can see here, if the angle arc of contact is 180 degree, in that case the value of this FD is equal to 1, and as you decrease this, your tension will increase, and therefore this factor will increase by the proportional amount, and if it is less than that, it will need to decrease. So now we will see that in the catalog, the given by the Dunlop transmissions, they have specified two different types of belts. Okay, and that belts are specified with certain power rating, or also called as load rating of the flat belts, in kilowatt per mm width per ply. So first they have given high speed duct belt. So this high speed duct belt is generally used for normal applications, and its power rating, or the load rating, is given as 0.0118 kilowatt per mm width per ply. While for the fork duct belt, which is used for heavy duty applications, the capacity, the power rating, is given as 0.0147 kilowatt per mm width per ply. And definitely this can be used in a speed range of 17.8 to 22.9 meter per second. So for arc of contact 180 degree and velocity v is equal to 5.08 meter per second, with standard width of these belts are available. So since they have tested this particular belt material under this particular speed using this arc of contact, okay, and then they have got these values of the power rating, and for these power ratings they come across with certain dimensions of the belts. So the width of the belt are specified here for the particular thickness of the belt. It means if the 3 ply belt, if it is there, so the widths which are available are 25, 40, 50, 63 and 76. Similarly for 4 ply, 5 ply, 6 ply, you will get different values of the belt widths. At the same time, there are some standard preferred diameters of the cast iron and mild steel pulleys in mm which are specified as 100, 102, 125. Like this, there are different standard values, so out of these some values you have to select for your particular application. So now we will see one by one the steps to be followed for selection of the belt. So just it is a summarizing now that what we have seen up till now. So first, what you have to do is, for your application, you have to assume the belt speed, which should be in the optimum range of 17.8 to 22.9 meters per second, and calculate the diameter of the pulleys D1 and D2. So once you get the diameters of D1 and D2, you may get some rough values. So you have to round up these values and select the preferred diameters from the above. Means in the last slide, I have shown you some standard values of the pulley diameters. From that, actually, you have to select a particular diameter of the pulley, and then check whether the actual velocity of the belt is within the optimum range or not. It means after rounding up the dimension of the pulleys, you will again calculate the velocity of the belt, and if that velocity of the belt again lies within the same range of 17.8 to 22.9, it means we can say that it is in the optimum range. So once you have got the dimensions of the pulleys, then you have to go for finding out the load correction factor and then find the maximum power KW max for the belt selection. So rated power you will calculate as per your requirement, then KW max you will calculate by multiplying it by factor FA depending upon the application, which we have seen how we can select the value of FA depending upon the type of loading. Then you have to calculate the arc of contact for smaller pulley and then find the arc of contact factor FD. So corresponding to the arc of contact of your smaller pulley, you will get the value of the FD, and this once you get this value of FD, then you have to calculate the corrected power. So this corrected power will be equal to the factor which you have just got from the value of the arc of contact. So FD multiplied by this KW max. So this KW max you have to use it over here. Okay, and multiply this FD with that KW max. So you will get the KW corrected. Now, after calculating this KW corrected, now you have to calculate the corrected power rating. So corrected power rating, now we have seen that there are two types of belts. One is high speed belt and another is a fork belt. So their power rating is specified to us in the catalog, and these power rating are calculated at a particular speed of 5.08. so what you have to do is, suppose if you have selected the high speed belt, so you have to calculate the corrected kilowatt rating for this high speed belt. So take this value of 0.0118, multiply your speed to this, okay, and divide by 5.08. so you will get the corrected kilowatt rating corresponding to your value of the speed of the belt or velocity of the belt. So after calculating this corrected kilowatt rating, then calculate the product of width multiplied by number of plies. So width multiplied by number of plies, this will be given by dividing the corrected power, okay, by corrected kilowatt rating. So corrected power you are getting over here, this corrected power, okay, this corrected power you have to divide by corrected kilowatt rating, means this one. Suppose you have selected this one, so this I will say 1 and this I will say 2. So when you take the ratio of this quantity 1 divided by 2, that will be equal to the width and the number of plies, its product. So suppose if you select number of any one number of plies, like suppose you initially select number of plies as 3, then find out the value of width. So this width, now you have to check whether it is available in this particular list or not. Suppose you have selected a number of plies as 3 and you got the value of width of the belt. So if there is some value near about value of this is available in this particular, like 25 or maybe 24 or something like 38 or 39, near about this value, if it is available in this, then you can say that it will be the value of that particular width of the belt. But if it is not, then you have to go for the next number of plies. So after selecting 3, then you can go for the number of plies as 4 and check the value of the belt width. If it is lies in this range, then it is okay. If not, then go for the number of plies as 5. If also this is not also satisfied, then go for the number of plies as 6. And so definitely somewhere you will get one of the value of the belt width which will match with this. So once we get that number of plies and the width, it means now we can see that we have selected that particular belt. So as we are assuming initially that we have gone for a high speed belt, so we are using this particular power rating, and you got certain number of plies as suppose 5, and then you are going to calculate the width corresponding to that number of plies. And once this is done, now the thing is remaining is to just calculate the length of the belt. So if it is open belt or cross belt, depending upon that we have to find out the length of the belt. So this is what we have done for a flat belt. So similarly, there will be analysis or design procedure for the V belts also. So there are certain differences in the V belt and the flat belt. So we will discuss what are those major differences are there in the V belt and the flat belt. So we'll find there are so many applications of the V belt industries. Actually, it is having a trapezoidal cross section, and the pulleys are also V shaped in which these belts will be mounted, and generally they are used for large power transmission. So at the same time, they are recommended for shorter center distances. And if you compare these belts with respect to the flat belts, so these drives are having less efficiency, and they can be used up to 1:15 transmission ratio, and the belt slip problem is not at all in this kind of belts, because it is having a groove, and in that groove that V belt is inserted, so definitely slip problem is not at all there in this case. And these V belts drives do not suffer from any joint failure, and they are very quiet in operation. And these V belts constitute the fabric and cords of cotton, nylon, etc., and impregnated with rubber. So in general, if you talk about the different application of the V belt, so whenever you will find out the electric motor is there as used as a prime mover, maybe for the compressor, positive displacement pumps, fans, blowers, petrol engine, diesel engines, or even in machine tools also, so you will find out that these V belts are used, and generally they are referring the velocity ratio up to 7:1. So this is what is the V belt cross section. The important dimensions of this V belt is nothing but the width of this belt on the top side, and this is nothing but the thickness of the belt, while this is the wedge angle or V angle, you can say, for the V belt cross section. So if you see the catalogs, there are so many standard V belt sections are available, which are called as section A, B, C, D and E, and the kilowatt rating is given for a particular section. So that indicates that the belt section selection depends solely on the power transmission required irrespective of the number of belts. And if the required power transmission falls in the overlapping zone, then one has to justify the selection from the economic point of view also. So it means if you see, refer to the table next on the next slide, you will understand that suppose now you can see here the this is the section given, this is the kilowatt range specified for the section, then minimum pulley pitch diameter is specified here, width of the belt and the thickness of the belt is specified. Suppose if I take the section B here, okay, the single belt of section B may be sufficient to transmit the power instead of two belts of section A. So this may increase the cost as well as weight of the pulley, as two grooved pulleys is required. Okay, so in general, it is better to choose that section for which the required power transmission falls in the lower side of the given range. It means suppose if we need a kilowatt range of 4, so instead of going for this section A of 4, or it is better to go for, because for the B it is in the lower range, because 4 for this it is in the range of 1.5 to 15, so 4 is in the lower range of this, so it is better to go for this B. Okay, now we will see the designation of the V belt. So in general, so inside length plus X is equal to the pitch length. For example, a B section belt with nominal inside length of 1016 mm or 40 inches is required for a V belt drive, then this V belt is designated as B1016/40. So this actually value 1016 is the length of inside length of the belt in mm. Okay, and the value of x corresponding to that belt A, B, C or D. So x value is specified here, so B, it is 40 specified, okay, like this, corresponding to this particular 43. So now we will see the V belt power rating. So each type of belt section has a power rating. The power rating is given for different pitch diameters of the pulley and different pulley speeds for angle of wrap of 180 degree. So for pitch diameter of D1, the power rating of the section A belt is KW1, KW2, KW3, KW4 for belt speeds of N1, N2, N3 and N4 respectively. So similar tables are available for the belts of other sections. So generally in case of V belt, the belt tension ratio is used as T1 minus MV square upon T2 minus MV square is equal to E raised to mu into alpha by sine of theta by 2. So mu is the coefficient of friction, alpha is the angle of wrap, and sine of this theta is nothing but the V angle or angle of the pulleys. So here we can see the standard tables are available because this kilowatt rating is specified for different speeds and constant angle of contact, angle of wrap as 100 degree, and for different N1, N2, N3 and N4 speeds. So accordingly, for a particular section of the belt and particular diameter, pitch diameter, you will get the different values of the powers like kilowatt 1, kilowatt 2, KW3 and KW4, like that. So now we will discuss about the V belt design factors. So this is same as we have seen in case of a flat belt. That is, to calculate the design power, we are multiplying the service factor to the required rated power. So generally this service factor for this kind of V belt drives is from 1.1 to 1.8 for light to heavy shock. So accordingly this design power will be calculated using the service factor. Then modification of the kilowatt rating. So power rating of a typical V belt section requires modification since the ratings are given for the conditions other than the operating condition. And what are those conditions are, so, and what are those factors are, that we will see. So first, equivalent smaller pulley diameter. So in belt drive, both the pulleys are not identical. Hence, to consider severity of the flexing, equivalent smaller pulley diameter is calculated based on the speed ratio. The power rating of the V belt is then estimated based on the equivalent smaller pulley diameter. So this equivalent smaller pulley diameter is given by the service factor multiplied by smaller pulley diameter, where this C subscript SR is a factor based on the speed ratio. Then there is a angle of wrap correction factor. So if the angle of wrap is less than or more than 100 degree, so accordingly we have to use this angle of wrap correction factor. Okay, and then next is the belt length correction factor. So there is an optimum belt length for which the power rating of a V belt is given, because it is not like a flat belt. So in case of flat belt, the long length of the belt is available, and as per our requirement we have to cut the belt length. But in case of V belts, standard fixed lengths of the belts are there. So therefore let us consider here that there is an optimum belt length for which the power rating of the V belt is given, and the belt length for length to be small, then so if the belt length is small, definitely that particular belt will be under tension and it has to work under higher forces. So therefore it is required that the correction factor should be used to modify the power rating of it, and therefore that correction factor is to be multiplied here to get the modified power rating of the belt. So power rating of the belt multiplied by CVW multiplied by CVL. So CVW is corresponding to the angle of wrap correction factor and CVL is corresponding to the belt length correction factor. Now we'll discuss the procedure for selection of the V belt. So first, the transmission ratio of V belt drive is chosen within the range of 1 to 15. Depending upon the power to be transmitted, a convenient V belt section is selected. Then once you select the section, the belt speed of the V belt drive should be around 20 meter per second to 25 meter per second, but should not exceed 30 meter per second. So from the speed ratio, the chosen belt speed pulley diameters are to be selected from the standard sizes available. So depending upon the available space, the center distance is selected. However, as a guidance, we can use this relationship for the center distance. So center distance should be more than DL and it should be less than DL plus DS. So where DL is the diameter of larger pulley and DS is the diameter of smaller pulley. So DL plus DS times 3 times of this. So your center distance should be less than this 3 and it should be more than the diameter of the larger pulley. Now the belt pitch length can be calculated if the C, DL and DS are known. Means if you know the center distance, if you know the diameter of larger pulley, if you know the diameter of smaller pulley, then we can find out the belt pitch length. So corresponding inside length then can be obtained from the given belt geometry. So nearest standard length selected from the design table and it is required for the required belt length. So from section above, the design power and the modified power rating of a belt can be obtained. So initially we have seen how we can calculate the design power, and then also we have seen how we can find out the modified power rating of the belt. So if you divide these two, then you will come to know that how many number of belts are required to be used for transmitting the power using that particular J belt. Okay, so this is what the procedure to be followed for selecting the V belt from the manufacturer's catalog. Now we will talk about in short about the belt tensioning methods. So there are different methods by which you are going to provide the tensioning to the belt. So first is by cutting the hinged belt and remove the slack. So if you found out that the belt is quite loose and you have to improve the tension of it, so you have to cut the belt at the hinge joint and again make the joint properly and slack can be removed. Otherwise, another way is that you can use this adjusting screw and change the center distance between the two pulleys. So if you increase the center distance in the pulleys, definitely it is possible to increase the tension in the belt. Or sometimes you can use the, when it is not possible to increase the center distance, you can use some idler pulley which will be pushed over the belt, and accordingly the belt tension can be increased. So idler pulley, you are going to adjust the weight over this particular pulley, so according to the weight your tension in the belt can be increased. Or in some cases you can use the mounting, pivoted mounting of the motor. So by changing the eccentricity of the one pulley with the other pulley, we can also change the center distance. So depending upon the application, actually we can use the different types of belt tensioning methods. So here I hope you understood how is to make the selection of the flat belt or the V belt from the manufacturer's catalog. Thank you very much.